गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास साईराम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक काइनेटिक थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस एंड द फर्स्ट टॉपिक और सब टॉपिक यू कैन से वी विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट इज बॉयल्स लॉ। ओके, सो व्हाट इज इट? एट कांस्टेंट टेम्परेचर, अकॉर्डिंग टू बॉयल्स लॉ, एट कांस्टेंट टेम्परेचर वॉल्यूम ऑफ ए गिवन मास ऑफ ए गैस इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू इट्स। ओके, so in all these laws like Boyle's law, Charles law and Galusek's law, or you can understand like ideal gas equation, okay, we have to consider a few things. Like we are talking about gases and those gases are contained in a certain vessel. Okay, suppose this is a kind of vessel and or you can say this is a container. In this container we have gas molecules. Okay, and these gas molecule will have, they will exert certain pressure on walls of the container, that is P, and the space occupied by these molecule, that is called volume, V, and temperature of the gas, that will be T. Okay, so it is saying that at constant temperature, if the temperature is constant, if we have fixed this T, temperature is constant, then volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Okay, and suppose this is your vessel and this portion is your piston, or you can say piston or lid of the container. Okay, if you will apply or if you will increase the amount of pressure on this vessel, on this piston, then this piston will go towards downward direction and we can say that volume of the gas will decrease. Okay, that's why it is saying that volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Or from here we can say that P into V, that is PV, is equal to constant. Second law is Charles law, and this law says that at constant pressure volume of a given mass of a gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. It means to say that if you have fixed the pressure, or if your pressure is constant, okay, you are not increasing pressure, neither pressure is decreasing. If pressure is constant, then volume is directly proportional to the temperature. Okay, suppose if you are providing some amount of heat to this container, then this volume of the gas will increase, or you can say gas will expand. Okay, and due to expansion of gases, we can say that our volume will increase. Volume at any temperature Vt is given by following relation, that Vt is equal to what? That is V naught. That means volume at in initial volume, and plus 1 plus T by 273.15. Okay, T is the amount of temperature. Okay, for 1 degree rise, this is the value for Vt. And if you are increasing temperature by some certain degree, suppose if your delta T is 5 degrees Celsius, then you have to put that value here and you will get volume at T temperature. After that, we have next law, that is called Galusek's law. According to this law, at constant pressure, at constant volume, pressure of a given mass is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. Okay, so it is saying that if you will increase the temperature, okay, if you will increase the temperature, then these gas molecule will get some energy. They will get some amount of energy, okay, heat energy. And due to that heat energy, their motion, thermal motion will increase inside this container, inside this vessel, their thermal motion will increase, due to which they will exert more amount of pressure on the walls of the container. So we can say that your pressure is directly proportional to temperature. If you will increase more amount of temperature, the gas molecule will get more amount of heat energy, and due to which their thermal motion will increase, and due to their thermal motion, you can say they will exert more amount of pressure on the walls of the container. So P by T is constant. For 1 degree Celsius rise in temperature, we can say our pressure can be calculated as Pt equal to P naught into 1 plus T upon 273.15. Pt is what? That is final pressure, okay, at T temperature, and P naught is what? That is initial pressure. After that, we have ideal gas equation. here you can understand for n mole of a gas, for n moles, okay, the pressure into volume, that PV equal to given by nRT, okay, where R is what, that is gas constant. If you will fix number of mole, suppose inside any container number of moles are constant, okay, then R is a gas constant, that is also constant, then we can say that PV is proportional to T. From here you can derive Boyle's law also, that Boyle's law gives you that at constant temperature PV is constant, okay. So from here you can understand, if your temperature is constant, T is also constant, however PV depends on temperature, but if your T is constant, then PV will be proportional to what? That will be proportional to nothing but a constant. So we can say that PV is constant. Again we have Charles law, and Charles law tells you what? It says that volume is proportional to temperature, but your pressure should be constant. Now from gas equation we can say that if your pressure is constant, P is constant, then we can say that volume is directly proportional to temperature, okay. So basically ideal gas equation is nothing but you can say that combination of Boyle's law and Charles law. And for 1 mole, if n equal to 1, we can say PV equal to RT. After that we have universal gas constant, value of it's given by 8.31 joule per mole per Kelvin. And Boltzmann constant KB is also defined R upon Na, means if we talk about for one molecule value of gas constant, okay, value of gas constant, that is R, that is called what? That is called Boltzmann constant, okay. It is nothing but gas constant, but for a single molecule. So we will divide it by number of molecule in a mole, that is Na. For one mole we have these many molecule, and R is what? 8.31. so you can get another constant, and Na is also called Avogadro number. After that, what is ideal gas? Definition of ideal gas is what? A gas which obeys gas law strictly is an ideal gas or perfect gas, okay. The molecule of such a gas are of point size, okay, and there is no force of attraction between them. Between gas molecule there is no intermolecular attraction force. Then we have some assumptions of kinetic theory of gases. What are these assumptions? First assumption is that all gases consist of molecule which are rigid elastic spheres identical in all respect for a given gas. Means here we are talking about these molecule of gases. Suppose inside a container if we have filled any ideal gas, then we are talking about the characteristics of these ideal gases or characteristics of these small molecule. It is saying that these small molecule, they are considered rigid elastic spheres and shape is considered as spherical, and in all ideal gases the same thing will be considered. Second point is that the size of molecule is negligible as compared with the average distance between the two molecule, okay. Between these two molecule we will have some certain gap, okay. With respect to this gap, size of the molecule is neglected. Third assumption is that during the random motion, the molecule collide with one another and with the wall of the vessel, the collision are almost instantaneous, okay. So it is saying that these molecule inside the vessel, they will always found on in thermal motion, okay. They always found in motion state, and they keep colliding with each other when they move. They collide with each other and they collide with wall also. And after that, next thing is that the molecular density remains uniform throughout the gas. Means at every portion, here, at every point, your density is constant. Or more specifically, we can say that our molecular density, that is the number of molecule in a portion of the vessel, will be constant. After that, point number 5, we have the collisions are perfectly elastic in nature and there is no force of attraction or repulsion between them. That means if these molecule will collide each other, then there will be no loss of energy, okay. They will if they are colliding with each other, then collision are considered to be perfectly elastic. After that, we have law of equipartition of energy. So for any thermodynamical system in thermal equilibrium, the energy of the system is equally divided amongst its various degree of freedom, and energy associated with each degree of freedom is corresponding to each molecule is 1/2 of kdVT. So next law we have, that is called law of equipartition of energy. So it says that if inside a gas molecule, or you can say inside a container, the energy is divided in every molecule in equal proportion, okay, and for one molecule, for its degree of freedom, that is the direction in which it can move, the amount of energy is given by half of kBT, okay, where kB is what, that is Boltzmann constant, because we are talking about a single molecule, and T is what, T is your absolute temperature, okay. Then law of equipartition of energy holds good for all degree of freedom, whether translation, rotation and vibration. Basically it is saying that any particle can, it may have three things, like it can translate, it can move from one point position to another position, it can rotate about its axis, or it can vibrate, okay. So all kind of three kind of kinetic energy we will have. It is moving, if it is moving, then it will have kinetic energy of translation. If it is rotating, then again it will have kinetic energy of rotation, okay, that is half I omega square. And similarly, if it is vibrating, then it will again have the energy. So second point is what, that is a monoatomic gas molecule has only translation kinetic energy. For that gas substance, or for that gas which has a single molecule, that is called monoatomic gas, okay. Those gases which have two molecules like oxygen, nitrogen, etc., it is called diatomic gases basically, okay. So here it is talking about those gases, like you can say helium, neon, argon, okay, krypton, xenon. These are noble gases, they are monoatomic, or you can consider some other gas also like helium, etc. These are also what, that are monoatomic, means single atom. So it is saying that a monoatomic gas molecule has only translation energy, and E translation plus rotational is given by half mvx square plus half mvy square plus half mvz square plus 3/2 of kBT. This kBT is what, that is kB basically Boltzmann constant, twice of kBT is what, Boltzmann constant. So this half mv square is what, that is the kinetic energy in x direction, and this is kinetic energy in y direction, and this is in z direction. For vibration, or for rotation, you can say the amount of energy is given by 3/2 of kBT, okay. So a monoatomic gas molecule has only three translation degree of freedom. In addition to translation kinetic energy, a diatomic gas molecule has two rotational energy, okay. For if diatomic gas is present over here like oxygen or nitrogen, then it can rotate, either it can rotate about y axis like in this way, okay, or it can rotate about z axis. Rotation about its own axis like this, this rotation is considered to be zero, because moment of inertia for such a system in which two molecules are given, okay, then moment of inertia about this axis, say Ixx, that will be considered as zero, because distance of the particle from its own axis, R will be zero. However, in this condition, your R is not zero. In fact, it will have some magnitude. So following expression gives you the value of translational plus rotational energy. And in this way, you can consider its rotational energy in this form, half I omega square. Okay, and if you are talking about Ixx, okay, Ixx is 0, so it will be Iy into omega y square plus Iz into omega z square. This will be the kinetic energy of the particle if it is rotating. Here the line to joining the two atom has been taken as x axis, about which there is no rotation. As I told you about this line which is x axis, there we will consider no rotation. So the degree of freedom of a diatomic molecule is 5. So degree of freedom means what? That means possible directions in which this molecule can go. This molecule can translate in x direction, इट कैन ट्रांसलेट इन वाई डायरेक्शन एंड इट कैन ट्रांसलेट इन जेड डायरेक्शन. मोर ओवर इट कैन रोटेट अबाउट दिस एक्सेस डेट इज जेड एक्सेस और इट कैन रोटेट अबाउट वाई एक्सेस ऑल्सो लाइक दिस वे. ओके बट इट कैन नॉट रोटेट अबाउट एक्स एक्सेस. सो टू काइंड ऑफ रोटेशंस आर पॉसिबल. ओके टू टाइप्स ऑफ रोटेशंस आर पॉसिबल एंड थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांसलेशंस आर पॉसिबल. ट्रांसलेशन मीन्स डायरेक्ट मोशन इन एनी सर्टेन डायरेक्शन. सो टोटल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी 5 फॉर डायटोमिक गैसेस. एंड नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज डैट एट वेरी हाई टेम्परेचर योर वाइब्रेशन इज ऑल्सो एक्टिवेटेड ड्यू टू विच 2 एक्स्ट्रा डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम इमर्ज फ्रॉम द वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी. सो इट इज सेइंग डैट फॉर एनी डायटोमिक गैस मॉलिक्यूल इफ़ यू इंक्रीज द अमाउंट ऑफ टेम्परेचर देन दिस मॉलिक्यूल विल वाइब्रेट अबाउट देयर मीन पोजिशन. ओके सो अगेन अ सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ मोशन विल स्टार्ट. सो 2 मोर डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम विल बी एडेड. सो ईच ट्रांसलेशन एंड रोटेशनल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम कॉरस्पॉन्ड्स टू 1 मोल ऑफ एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ एनर्जी एंड डेट हैज़ हाफ ऑफ के वी. ओके